In this video, we're going to go through the compass page on the Garmin Montana 700. This also can apply to the 710 or the 750i model. So we are using the recreational profile, and this is the current compass page. We're not navigating to a point, but we can access all the features or menu options here by tapping on the menu. And we'll go through this one by one here. So first thing we have is the sight and go. This is a useful feature here. This is as close to old school map and compass navigation as you can get using the device. Montana 700 has an electronic compass on it. We'll take a look at the calibration a little bit later. You can see here that we have a bearing. So if you're doing some map and compass and you need to get a direction, notice here that we're, as I pivot or I point the GPS in a direction of travel, we can lock in a bearing, lock a direction, and then you can either project a waypoint or set a course. So if I project a waypoint, that means that I can go in that direction. So if you're bushwhacking through the woods and you want to go a couple hundred meters, so for example, I like to go 300 meters in this particular bearing, I can set it. And it projected a waypoint, and then now I can save, and now I can navigate to that. So the compass will be locked on that, and we'll be able to get to that. Let's get back to our navigation, and we can stop navigation. Course will be somewhat similar. Again, we're gonna lock in the direction of travel, and let's set the course. And now now the compass is locked in, and we're using the CDI compass here. And basically we can see that we have our direction of travel, we have our where our course is, and you probably notice here that we have this 0.25 meter, and that refers to the dots. So as we're bushwhacking, we may become off course, and this long line will start to drift right or left, and by each tick it will give us an indication how far off we'll be off course, for example. So that's the course, that's the CDI map face here. So for those who are old school map and compass, this will probably be familiar to you. All right, let's stop this navigation here. Let's move on to the next one, which is our change dashboard. So here we can customize the look of our page here. So we can, the dashboard is set to small data fields, but we can change it to something else. So we can change it to large data fields, and you can see that the page itself has changed. We can go back again, change dashboard, and we can do status, have that. One more time, change dashboard. I personally like the small data field, right? Of course, now you want to maybe customize some of these data fields, but you can't. Again, let's tap on menu, unlock data fields, and now you can tap in, and now you can change whichever field that you want to do. Off course, and let's do, right? Like that. Once we have our fields, data fields specified, we can tap on menu and lock it so that now we don't have to have it accidentally change on us. Next option here is the calibrate compass. You don't necessarily have to do this as much anymore on some of these newer GPSs, but in case that you do notice that the GPS, the electronic compass, is a bit off, this is how you find the spot to calibrate it. Tap on that. Now we can go through the calibration steps. This will have, this will make you rotate the device on the three axis. So this will take some practice. I may not be able to do this here on the shot. I need a little bit more working room here, but let's see what we got here. So we'll start with the first one, which is just to rotate the device like that. That's good. Let's do the next one, and so this one here is very important to see if we can get that. All right. And the next one is to flip it like that. So let's see if we are able to do that. All right, perfect. So now our compass is properly calibrated now. So that should improve things if you do notice things are a bit off. And next up, we have the heading set up. All right, so now we can play around with the display, directional letters. All right, we have the numerical degrees in mils. We have our north reference, true magnetic grid or user. The go to line, it's on medium bearing. You can also have a large bearing if I go back here, right, when we're navigating to a point. All right, large bearing. Let's go here and go to our heading and let's change it again. You can see medium, let's change it to small, show you what that looks like. And of course, you can also use the CDI course face. Right. What else that you can do? Let's change this back to medium. And now we have our compass, it's on. Let's turn this off, see what happens to it. So you can see here that our electronic compass is off. That means that we have to get our direction of travel. We have to do the old fashioned way, which is to start moving. And then the GPS will use the satellites and our change in position to figure out what is our direction of travel. But we can go back here and turn this back on. Of course, we still got our calibrate compass, which is here also in our menu. And finally, last thing, if you've done too much customization, you want to start fresh, basically you can hit restore defaults and that should bring you back to just like it was out of the box. And there you go. That is the compass page on the Garmin Montana 700.